Eyewitness News.
Wow, what a talented right. young lady. And great to see the programs bouncing back.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Oh. It'd be nice to have them work here in their own home. I mean, you heard about other opportunities.
Absolutely.
In other places.
Yes.
All right, you're at work this morning. I mean, this is a beautiful shot this morning. We need the sun to come back. It's been raining the past couple of days.
Yeah. Yes, we've had some real soaking rainfall. In fact, out on Long Island, some of the amounts are closing in on 2 inches of rainfall that we saw from that storm. So, pretty impressive amount of rain, real soaking rainfall. This live view from the Jersey Shore looking out over the ocean, 44 degrees. We do have some clouds around, but the sun will break through at times. It'll take our temperatures up. Yesterday's high was 53. We're starting with the low 40s this morning. Winds are a lot calmer. It was brisk at times yesterday with those strong winds coming through. Winds have settled down. Clouds will give way to some sunnier skies, and that's going to allow the temperatures to come up. So right now in Newburgh, we have 41 degrees, 40 for Armonk. Yonkers has 43. Northwest New Jersey also in the low 40s this morning. Newark at 42. Belmar has 44. We could add 10 to maybe 15 degrees to these temperatures, getting us close to the normal for this time of year, which is 62. I don't think we quite beat that number, but we're going to get pretty close to it. 96 is the record set back in 2002. Sunset will be at 7:38 this evening. A look at the big picture here, and you can still see the circulation out off New England, off the coastline of this larger system that was bringing in the moisture and the showers and the rain that we had, and getting over an inch and a half, almost 2 inches of rainfall in places like Islip. There are a few sprinkles this morning for north central New Jersey. Those are going to come and go, and hardly enough to get the sidewalk wet. So not really anything to worry about. Clouds give way to some sun breaks, and that'll push our temperatures into the upper 50s. Again, tonight we fall back into the 40s, clear skies, and Sunday should start even a little bit brighter. But after that sunny start, the clouds are back in for the afternoon. Won't rule out the possibility of a sprinkle, but we're not looking for any soaking showers or drenching downpours here over the weekend. Early on Monday, temperatures will start in the mid-40s to near 50 degrees, setting the stage for an even warmer day on Monday. Air quality is good, so weather wellness, UV index is at a 4, moderate. Pollen counts are high, with trees being the main concern. We'll go for 59, and then tomorrow, our temperatures get a head start with the upper 40s, so we should be able to make 64 with just an isolated shower or sprinkle around. By Monday, it's 66, a few showers still in the forecast. Tuesday, it's a warmer mix, a high of 72, so not bad at all. Showers do return on Wednesday and take our temperatures back down to the low 60s. 57 on Thursday, some chilly air coming in with the winds that day, back up to 64 on Friday. So a little bit of an up and down, you guys, but if you're looking for the warmest day of the week, definitely going to be Tuesday. Back to you.
All right, looking forward to that. Climate change certainly is reshaping communities. Coastal flooding is just one of the topics the ABC meteorologist and National Geographic will tackle during an hour-long special. Our America Climate of Hope is now available to watch on our streaming apps, and you can watch the special right here on Channel 7 today at 1.